parsley in a special way. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In order to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do,
through my fault,
through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Pour your grace into our hearts, we pray, O Lord, that we may be constantly drawn away from unruly desires and obey by your own gift the heavenly teaching you give us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, Return, O Israel, to the Lord your God. You have collapsed through your guilt. Take with you words and return to the Lord. Say to him, Forgive all iniquity and receive what is good, that we may render as offering the bullocks from our stalls. Assyria will not save us, nor shall we have horses to mount. We shall say no more, our God, to the work of our hands. For in you the orphan finds compassion. I will heal their defection, says the Lord. I will love them freely, for my wrath is turned away from them. I will be like the dew for Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall strike root like the Lebanon cedar and put forth his shoots. His splendor shall be like the olive tree and his fragrance like the Lebanon cedar. Again, they shall dwell in the shade and raise grain. They shall blossom like the vine, and his fame shall be like the wine of Lebanon. Ephraim, what more has he to do with idols? I have humbled him, but I will prosper him. I am like a verdant cypress tree. Because of me, you bear fruit. Let him who is wise understand these things. Let him who is prudent know them. Straight are the paths of the Lord. In them the just walk, but sinners stumble in them. The word of the Lord. I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
An unfamiliar speech I hear. I relieved his shoulder of the burden. His hands were freed from the basket. In distress you called and I released you.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
Unseen, I answered you in thunder. I tested you at the waters of Meribah. Hear my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, will you not hear me?
I am the Lord your God. Hear my voice.
There shall be no strange God among you, nor shall you worship any alien God. I, the Lord, am your God, who led you forth from the land of Egypt.
I am the Lord your God. Hear my voice.
If only my people would hear me, and Israel walk in my ways, I would feed them with the best of wheat, and with honey from the rock I would fill them.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory.
One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this: Hear, O Israel, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher, you are right in saying he is one and there is no other than he, and to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I was struck by the word, I will hear their defection, says the Lord. I will hear their defection. Think of God recognizing that in us is a defect, right? A defection. There's a defect. You order something and it's not what it was supposed to be. It was produced incorrectly. He said there's a defect here. The dictionary defines it as a lack of something necessary for perfection. It's not just a lack of perfection. Oh, it's built with a defect. Something necessary for perfection. So if we have this defect, we can't become perfect, right? There's a lack of what is necessary for us to become perfect. So he is going to move into our hearts, move into our lives to heal that defect, take away what's keeping us from being able to be perfect. I think we've noticed this, hopefully you've noticed this in your life, and you pay attention and you think, I gotta go to confession again, or why do I go to confession again? It's just the same stuff, you know? I must be boring to the priest. Yes, your sins are very boring to me, all right? So, but what is that? Well, there's kind of this system in us that is broken at some point, and yeah, I kind of had this good intention. That hits that spot, and it shows up crooked, right? It just gets off track, and so I just found myself constantly just recognizing this, and I just can't make any growth, any progress. I'm just so frustrated. So this image of something that would grow and bear good fruit doesn't seem to happen. Rather, it just keeps popping up, the bad fruit. I pull it off each Lent and I throw it away, and I pull it off the next Advent and I throw it away, and pull it off the next Lent and I throw it away. I need God to get into here, right? There's a defect. There's something that I can't perfect this. I can't move past this. There's something wrong in the roots of this system. Of course, it keeps bearing bad fruit. The issue's down there in the roots. There's something obviously very powerful to let ourselves realize, well, God wants to visit you there. He wants to come down to the root of the problem. You know, if you're charged by your parents with weeding the front garden and all you've done is kind of snapped off the top of the weeds and ran back to playing basketball, they find out real quick, don't they, right? About 10 days you're back there in the garden. You know? If you had worked down to the roots, well, you might have been able to play basketball 10 days later. You wouldn't have been back in the garden. Lord, I want you to get right down in there so we can really play and be free and be who I'm called to be. So we stay with that image, that kind of really rooting things out, letting God come and change the roots. We hear the rest of this later on. I'm like the verdant cypress tree, because of me you bear fruit. Right. I can't bear the fruit, but because of you I'll be able to. If you can heal that wound that is setting things off track, I could know that you were there. That time I felt so alone and so afraid, I don't have to spend the rest of my life trying to prove this or fix that or show that. No, you were with me. I wasn't alone. There's a whole new set of tracks now, and suddenly there is positive fruit growing. Because of God, we can bear fruit. So as we kind of hit crunch time here in Lent, and we're really moving closer to Holy Week, keep in mind the chances for reconciliation here. Right? The Wednesdays at 6, Saturdays at 4, and of course the Lent is on coming up Monday of Holy Week. Let God God into the roots. Let him show you how he had always been there. Undo the lies and the stuff that kind of makes you bear bad fruit, and watch as good fruit can be born with our Lord. He's making sure to take away the defect so that we can reach perfection. Stand together and make our needs known to our God. We continue to pray for Pope Francis, for all of our church leaders, that they would welcome the Lord into the defections in their lives, that they might be made more holy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We pray for world leaders, those charged with caring for those most vulnerable among them, that they would have the courage to step out and do what is right for those who are weakest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our own hearts, our own lives, we may be called to a deeper repentance this Lent and be willing to invite God into those painful places in our life that we might be able to bear new fruit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have hurt us, that we may have the courage to forgive them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those we have hurt, that they might have the courage to forgive us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick and the suffering, those who face surgery these days, that the Lord might bring them quickly to healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Tina Marie Parsley and for all of our beloved deceased, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bring God the prayers and petitions which we carry in our hearts. For one another's needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, thank you for healing in us what we cannot do for ourselves. Keep us always close to you in holiness and make us strong by answering the prayers we bring to you today through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, Lord, on the offerings we dedicate, that they may be pleasing in your sight and always be salutary for us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord,
God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you in need of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead and look forward to his blessed coming. We offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis our Pope, Douglas our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, unto the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, Prayer for spiritual communion as we pray with our friends at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. May your strength be at work in us, O Lord, pervading our minds and bodies, that what we have received by participating in this sacrament may bring us the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Continue prayer for end of the pandemic. O Mary,
full of grace, patroness of this nation and mother of the church, in this time of illness and worldwide need, we seek your intercession for the human family before your Son's throne of grace and mercy. We ask for strength in adversity, health in weakness, and comfort in sorrow. Help us, O Blessed Mother, to be filled with confidence and trust in the tender compassion of our God. Let us not be afraid, like our own St. Mary Ann Cope, who entrusted her life in ministry among the outcasts of society, into the care of our divine physician. Continue to watch over all who are sick, as well as those who care for them, and give wisdom to all who are seeking a cure. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Of course, we invite you to stay a little bit today, pray in adoration. And for those who have the sun in their eyes this morning, don't worry, by Monday I'll take care of that. It won't be in your eyes. Don't forget to turn the clocks back. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Spirit.
Amen.